Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thanks, Chris, for giving me the opportunity to speak this morning. Chris originally asked me to speak at the beginning of this year, but circumstances came up that prevented me from doing so until now. And I'll get to that a little bit later. Growing up, my mother always thought that I should be a priest. She's 88 years old now, and in the last 5 years, she has fallen and broken her hip, had two knees replaced, and is now recovering from broken ribs. She's quite remarkable. Believe me, she would be very excited to see me up here in this pulpit. This is the closest I'll ever be to becoming a priest. A couple of weeks ago, Jess asked the question, why do you come to this church? Let me start there and tell you why I come to this church. By way of introduction, I was raised Catholic and one of eight children, and religion was very important to me. When Barb and I got married right here in St. Martin's 15 years ago, I moved out to this area. Every Sunday, I would go off to a Catholic church service, and Barb would go in a different direction. When my daughter Megan came along, I remember saying to Barb, doesn't matter where we go to church, but we're going to church as a family. So we chose St. Martin's, and we've been here ever since. We feel very much at home here. There's a saying that goes like this. You only get out of something what you put into it. The whole Pettit family is very involved in St. Martin's, and we certainly feel that we get out of St. Martin's more than we put in. Here at St. Martin's, we're a small community with a limited number of people and resources. Year after year, though, many of you continue to demonstrate an amazing commitment to this faith and to this church. And for those of you waiting for an invitation to jump in, consider this your invitation. I encourage all of you to volunteer and give back, and do so in new ways, by trying a new ministry and or stretching a bit and giving more financially. My hope is that you will experience the deep reward that comes from giving of yourselves to the glory of God. The rewards of this season of sacred portion are not just about monetary giving. It's all about giving back. If we all do a little bit, we can accomplish so much more. As Mark tells us in the Gospel today, whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you must be a slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. Part of my life journey and search for deeper meaning involves a search for meaningful life work. At the end of the day, I want to know that I made a difference. I don't know where this search will lead me, but I put my faith in God. Every day I pray that God will continue to be in my life, guide me to do his will, and provide for my family and me. I don't know what God has in store for me, but I do know that he's been there for me in the past, and I know in my heart that he will be there for us in the future. Barb and I recently went to a wedding of my cousin's daughter. The priest started his homily with this story. In preparation for the big proposal, the groom asked my cousin Brian, the father of the bride, for his daughter's hand in marriage. The father asked the young man how he was going to take care of his daughter. The young man said, I have a good job, and God will provide for us. The father told the young man that his daughter is used to the finer things in life, and asked, will you be able to give them to her? To which the young man replied, don't worry, God will provide for us. The father repeated that his daughter was used to a certain standard of living, and will want that to continue in her married life, and how he will be able to give those things to her. The young man held fast in his faith and repeated, don't worry, God will provide for us. So my cousin Brian went home to his wife Diane, and Diane asked, well, how did it go? Brian said with a twinkle in his eye, it went well. He thinks I'm God. A little church humor. But on a serious note, the point is, through faith and prayer, God will provide for you and each and every one of us, and for St. Martin's. Let me tell you about my life's journey this past year in particular. It started this time last year when Father Chris gathered for my spiritual discernment four incredible members of this congregation: Linda Alunco, Alicia Culver, Joe Pergiovanni, and Sandy Reinhardt. We would gather once a month, and they would listen. And they would listen. They did not tell me what I should do. They didn't tell me what I shouldn't do. They listened. They did not give me advice. They listened. They asked me questions. I shared what was going on in my life, and they listened. The whole process of discovery was amazing, enlightening, and empowering. And I would like to sincerely thank them for their friendship, support, and encouragement. Linda, Joe, Sandy, and Alicia, and of course Chris, I'm eternally grateful for the time that we spent together. You unselfishly gave of your time to help another, a true sacrifice that I hope has come back to you many times over. Now to the circumstances for rescheduling of my sermon. At the beginning of this year, a dear friend suggested I attend a seminar called the Landmark Forum. Landmark is a weekend-long program that is truly transformative. It saved my life in more ways than one. It taught me that anything I want for myself or anything in my life is possible. It also literally saved my life. On my way to the first class, on a bitterly cold day in January, I was walking down Market Street from Market East Station, and I started feeling chest pains and pains down my arms. Classic heart attack symptoms. I arrived at my destination, went into the building, and the pains went away with the warmth of the building. Over the course of the next month or so, the pains came back a few more times. God was clearly giving me a sign, and thankfully I listened and took action. I listened to God and my body, and off to the doctor I went. Things moved very quickly from there, and we were reminded of the power of prayer. After a brief consultation with the doctor, he disappeared down the hallway and came back to me and said, "You have an appointment with the cardiologist tomorrow." So I went the next morning, near blizzard conditions. It did not take long for the cardiologist to realize that there was no time to waste, and she scheduled me for a stress test. I had to go straight in for a heart catheterization, and the question was whether it would be the next day on Friday or that Monday. Time was of the essence. As uncertain a time as it was, we never felt alone. The outpouring of love and prayers from this congregation was overwhelming. So that Monday, we again put our faith in God, and Barbara and I headed down the thorn to the hospital at the University of Pennsylvania. Three blockages and various tests later, double bypass surgery was scheduled for May 11th. After spending 6 days in the hospital, I returned home and began my recuperation. Talked in the past couple of weeks of Jesus being a preacher, a friend, a teacher, and a healer. And I can certainly attest to Jesus being a healer. What I went through was nothing short of a miracle. Tomorrow is my birthday, but now I consider May 11th a second birthday. I was given a second chance at life on May 11th. Through the love and support of this church community, prayers were answered, and once again, God showed me that he has a plan for each one of us. One of the things I have learned at Landmark is the importance of stretching yourself to get in the game. This relates to St. Martin's and the season of sacred portion. Do things to support the church that you never considered before. Strike up a conversation with someone new. bring food to the St. Barnabas Barrel, or attend one of our many events. Read the cloak as a way to become connected. Please know that each one of you is important to the growth and vitality of this church. I recently attended a luncheon where Lou Ann Kahn was the keynote speaker. As many of you know, Lou Ann wrote a book entitled I Dare Me, detailing her long journey, her year-long journey, in which every day she tried something new. At the end of the luncheon, Lou Ann challenged everyone in the audience to write down one thing they were going to do and the date that they were going to do it. As she was walking around the room, I could tell she was looking for volunteers to share. My hand went right up, and this is what I shared with the group. This Friday, October 23rd, I will be one of many rappelling down a 1 Logan Square, a 31-story building in Center City. Yep, 31 stories. Talk about getting out of your comfort zone. Building Adventure 2015 is an annual event to raise money and awareness for Outward Bound Philadelphia, an organization that teaches leadership skills to inner city youth through outdoor adventures. Whether it's Outward Bound or here at St. Martin's, collaboration is critical as it helps us transcend our individual limits create something greater than ourselves. Stand for Iraqi Christians is a perfect example. Call it giving back, paying it forward. We all need to do our part. It really does feel good when we know that this little church in Radnor is making a difference in the world. So I leave here with a question to ponder, and that is, how will you serve God through St. Martin's? Amen.
Amen.